Hey guys, Sharky here in the Orange Seas, because the creator of this mock used a few mudguards as the Warner, and I'm hilarious. I'm a comedic genius. Anyway, today I'm going to be reviewing another mock of set 42093. I think I'm soon going to stop making these and go back to the base model. There is one mock I'm thinking of still doing though. Anyway, this is a mock, meaning there's no box or instructions, and the instructions are digitally available via the brick link in the description below. Apart from that, let's jump straight into the mock. It has three play features, which is pretty impressive considering what it is and its part limitations, but I'll leave the best till last. And I'll start with this grey thing, which I think is supposed to be some kind of sculpture. Thought it looked like a person on pure coincidence, but yeah, you can pull them off the front here and attach them to the back, or this black thing as the instruction suggested, which I thought was kind of weird. I don't know why you put it there unless you don't like it and you want to hide it, but yeah, I think it looks best at the front, so I'm just going to put it back here. Anyway, on to the next second play feature. If you go to the back, you'll notice there's two levers, and if you pull them down, it reveals these two cannons, and if you pull them back up, they're hidden again. If you make the cannons very straight, like it would be on a real pirate ship, it kind of locks up the mechanism, but that's no one's fault, and if you care about how the cannons look, you're likely going to leave them on display like that instead of, you know, playing with the play feature. You're probably just going to leave it as it is. Anyway, now on to the last and most exciting play feature in this set, and that's this lever on the side. There's no lever on the right side, that's where the orange waves are, as there's no blue pieces in this set, unless you count the pins, of course. But yeah, if you go back to here, I found it's best that you grab onto this grey piece and wind the crank. You'll see the boat moves up and down, and the waves actually do as well if I try and operate it while it's facing me. You can see those waves move, and that leads me to my first complaint, as there's a lot of tension in this model. I found a lot of pieces seem to have to bend inward and in wacky ways to make it look like this. So if you have this one set and you rebuild it like me, like if you grab like the set and you just rebuild it instead of buying multiple, I'd say that you shouldn't leave it like this for long, as it would likely affect the longevity of the pieces unless I built it. But yeah, if you look in here, the pressures cause these pieces to collapse, and the mechanism requires those pieces to be together. So now I'm gonna speed up footage of me trying to reattach it. Anyway, apart from that, that's all I can say about this mock. Check out the links in the description. I'd also say the mock instructions were a bit confusing sometimes, but I've used Bricklink Studio before, and that's likely the reason, as I had the same problems when making my mock myself. That's all I can say about this mock, so thanks for watching and goodbye.